Welcome to the Short Book Summaries channel. If you are new to this channel, kindly consider subscribing this channel to stay updated on each new book coming to this world. In case you like and want to buy this book, the link is given in the description below. Now enjoy the summary. Khalil Gibran's masterpiece, The Prophet, is one of the most beloved classics of our time. Published in 1923, it has been translated into more than 20 languages, and the American editions alone have sold more than 9 million copies. The Prophet is a collection of poetic essays that are philosophical, spiritual, and, above all, inspirational. Gibran's musings are divided into 28 chapters covering such sprawling topics as love, marriage, children, giving, eating and drinking, work, joy and sorrow, housing, clothes, buying and selling, crime and punishment, laws, freedom, reason and passion, pain, self-knowledge, teaching, friendship, talking, time, good and evil, prayer, pleasure, beauty, religion, and death. Now that I'm reading The Prophet again, words that I read 27 years ago still ring clearly in my mind as I read them again today. It was a wonderful moment a few evenings ago to find myself reciting aloud and from memory passages that had struck me then and now to the very core. Khalil Gibran spent a couple of years revising The Prophet. Since it is a short book, the concepts come across as distilled. The influences of his native Lebanon as well as his love for scripture come through in the scriptural-like language. I am savoring this book slowly this time, taking little sips at a time. Reread a classic to start off the new year. As with every classic, this too turned up in a new light. With echoes of Schopenhauer, Kant and even Comte, this deep poem suddenly took new life in this reading. Now what is left is to search out which way the influence spread before flowering in this expression, east to west, the other way, or is it an early amalgamation of all philosophy like all truly great poems are?